are at an all-time low. We need ideas and we need them fast. Yes, Cletus. Personally, I think that we should add more memes to our movies. You know, kids love that. Dabby dab dab. How do you do, my fellow millennials? Kids like Minions, right? Yes, everything you say is true, Cletus, but I just don't think that's going to get our ratings up. Cedric, go!
Add more jokes only the parents understand.
No, we have plenty of those. Dance sequences! More dance sequences! Maybe. What, Jim? You know, it's just a thought, but maybe even more unique concepts, or take some surveys and see what- GARBAGE! Guys, come on! Seriously, anything! Frederick?
Huh?
What?
Why don't we just, I don't know. Make live action versions of all our movies?
Frederick, that is the most brilliant idea I have ever heard. Live action movies. Our company's running out of ideas. Are they as greedy and money grubbing as we presume? Will we ever see an original movie again? And why are the cats in the Cats movie so terrifying? I'll try to answer all of these questions, but first, some backstory. Live action remakes of movies that already exist, as far as I know at least, started with Disney's remake of The Jungle Book in 1994. And then, get this, they decided to make another remake of The Jungle Book in 2016. Why? Though Disney began this trend and continues to make more live action movies than virtually any other companies have jumped on the bandwagon with movies such as The Sonic Movie. Yes, The Sonic Movie. And I feel so bad for those poor animators that have to redo Sonic because the entirety of Twitter freaked out, but I must say, his teeth make me very uncomfortable. And the Cats movie, which, like, I don't even know, like, the musical's already, like, extremely weird and confusing, and the animation is just, like, it's just not cute. And the James Corden cat really freaks me out. Like, what is that? What is that? So, why do companies do this? I can only think they do this because, well, to put it frankly, they want money. Which, I mean, is the whole point of a company, but with a company as huge as, like, Disney, they really have no shortage of funds, and I feel like more people would see a movie with an original concept than something we've already seen. Will we ever see an original movie again? Yes, probably. Just not as much as we used to. Because here's the kicker, even though most people hate live-action remakes, they continue to see them because they want to see how bad they messed up the movie. We're really plotting our own downfall here, people.
Number 1. VR skin.
In case seeing everything in a game wasn't good enough for you, now you can feel it. Scientists have developed a new kind of skin to wear around you while you're playing a game. Now, not only while you're playing VR, you can have a TV on your face, but you can also have a full bodysuit caressing you the entire time. Sounds like nothing could ever happen that's weird because of it.
Number 2. Genetically modified mosquitoes.
Ever thought about mosquitoes and just been like, wow, I wish they were more dangerous. That malaria and the Zika virus just wasn't, like, bad enough. Well now, thanks to an English biotech company, your dreams have come true. They have put in what they call a lethal gene in mosquitoes to kill off all native mosquitoes And that's pretty dangerous. Sounds really safe. Luckily for humans, the only way that this lethal gene is spread is through mating. So if you end up dying through a mosquito, there will be many questions.
Number 3. Samsungs can call computers.
Yay! Finally, what all 6 of us Samsung users have been waiting for. We can finally call our computers! Yeah! Windows has just released an update to where you can call computers off your Samsungs. Finally, Samsungs have something over an Apple. We don't need FaceTime or iMessage games. We just can get lonely and call our computers.
Number 4. Charmin Forever Roll.
Ever sat down at the John and realized you're at a TP, but it's too late? I know I have, and it sucks. But thanks to Charmin's new Forever Roll, that is no longer an issue. The new Charmin Forever Roll has 2,550 individual squares of toilet paper, spanning 278 square feet of toilet paper. It's a lot of toilet paper. If you ever need more than that, you need to go to a hospital. Charmin Forever Roll. It won't stop until you do.
Are you looking to expand your inner circle of friends? Look for someone to fly a drone with. How about play some Uno during one lunch? Maybe your friends are a little trash and need to hit the reset button. Well, I got the thing for you. Here at PAX, we are very lucky to have a diverse student body and staff. Let's go see who's into what, and maybe, just maybe, you will meet some people that share your interests.
What is your name?
My name is Taya Sloan.
Hi. So, what's your secret talent?
I'm really good at video games.
What is your name?
Wes.
What is your favorite show to binge watch?
Twin Star Exorcist.
What is your name?
Skylar.
What is your biggest fear?
Clowns.
What is your name?
Jocelyn.
Who do you admire most in life?
Michelle Obama.
What is your name?
Jalil.
What skill do you want to learn?
Drawing better.
What is your name?
Jay.
Jay, what is your talent?
I can juggle.
What is your name?
Amy Anderson.
Who do you admire most in life?
My mom.
What is your name?
Isabella.
What is something nobody knows about you?
I'm on the wrestling team.
What is your name?
Zakiya.
Zakiya, what are you most afraid of?
I'm afraid of not being accepted by people.
What is your name?
Kira Moore.
Hello, Kira. What is something not everyone knows about you?
I've been to Japan and Australia.
Hello, what is your name?
Miss Crosby.
What is your favorite TV show to binge watch?
I have many of them, but I love House of Cards.
Hello, what is your name?
Mr. Deal.
Hello, Mr. Deal. What is something nobody knows about you?
Well, back when I was in my 20s, I was a youth minister. And a church that we attended.
Is your name?
Hi, Dawn Mahar.
Hi, Ms. Mahar. What is something not everyone knows about you?
Something that no one knows about me. I am a Disney World freak, and if I could have it my way, I would be living in Disney World right now.
Oh, thank you.
So, you're looking to have some fun this holiday? Well, make sure you follow these simple rules while you have your spooky fun. Rule number 1, always say trick or treat when you show up to a house. If you don't say trick or treat, they legally do not have to give you candy. Rule number 2, don't show up to a party without a costume. Nobody likes the guy who's just standing there in a corner in a regular clothes after they took the time to get into their costume. Rule number 3, don't pick a lame costume. So you found your dad's cummerbund, and now you think you're James Bond. Wrong, wrong, wrong. Rule number 4. It's okay to revisit a house as long as you change your costume. Think about it. If a house is giving out full-size candy bars, wouldn't you want 2 candy bars instead of 1? Rule number 5. Be polite. These people are giving you out candy for free. The least you could do is give them a smile. Thank you. Rule number 6. If they give you a toothbrush, anything goes. Rule number, I forgot what number we were on. Make sure to have fun and eat lots of candy. Rule number next. Make sure you take down your Halloween decorations within a week of Halloween. November 1st is way too long to still have those up. You need to start getting ready for Thanksgiving. Those are the rules I think are important. The really important thing is to stay safe and have fun.
Spooky sports. Football's 5-2. Last Friday they went to Lackey on Lackey's homecoming and beat them 35-21. Now first in the Smack Chesapeake Division, we face Calvert. Ew. Let's get up there and make it loud. Let's make Calvert forget that they have a home game. We're fighting to be number one. Let's go. The game is at 7 o'clock. Get to Calvert. Field hockey is now 9-3, also putting it to Lackey. It's a rough time to be Lackey, but oh well. The girls are working hard to be fully prepared for playoffs. They have a home playoff game on Monday. Volleyball is now 7-5 and got things back on track this week with wins against Lackey. And hopefully they beat Westlake, but honestly, I don't know. Because, once again, film this on Thursday. I don't know the outcome. So hopefully they won. I hope. Also, the Huntingtown game. Robbery. Straight up, that's all I can say about it. In fact, let's take a look at what happened.
Point.
What?
Thank you, Garrett. Cross country. Well, they're running really fast, and they keep getting better. Soccer, they're starting over. They went on a rough streak, but it's okay. Now starts playoffs. They travel up to Potomac on Saturday at 10 o'clock. Girls soccer, well, their playoffs started as well. And Crossland, well, we beat them. That's all I have to say. Calvert Saturday. Let's go, girls. Golf. Nick Boswell hit a hole in one at practice. That was this week's sports recap. I'm Garrett Witt.
You see money all around me. I look like I'm the man. Yeah, but I was counting out like last week.
And this week in sports, Lamar Jackson joined company of Colin Kaepernick and Michael Vick for a rushing record of quarterbacks. He got over 150 rushing yards in a single game. Zion Williamson underwent knee surgery Monday to repair a torn meniscus in his right knee, and he's expected to miss 6 to 8 weeks. Hopefully he's not the next Greg Oden. The Ravens beat the Bengals 23-17 and then went on to beat the Seahawks 30-16. The Redskins are god-awful. They lose almost every game, but they won one game versus the Miami Dolphins by 1 point, and then they lost to the 49ers 9-0. Scherzer and Cole pitch game one of the World Series with a final score of 5-4. The Nationals' Juan Soto is an absolute freak of nature. In case you didn't know, he's 20 years old.
Third youngest player, as you saw, and he hit cleanup in a World Series, and he just cleaned up.
Penn State beat Michigan 28-21, and Maryland plays Minnesota this upcoming Saturday, hoping to pull off an impressive upset. A new king of L.A. was crowned when the Clippers beat the Lakers at a huge L.A. matchup, 112-102. Cain Velasquez signed a multi-year deal with the WWE. Tyson Fury also to appear in Saudi Arabia match for $15 million. Hockey, well, no one really cares till the playoffs. But for those who care, the Buffalo Sabres have been on an absolute tear as they sit atop the Atlantic Division with a record of 8-2. The Capitals also sit atop of their respective division with a record of 7-4. This has been This Week in Sports. I'm Brady Powell. See you next week.
It's amazing, so amazing, so amazing.
Are you cultured? Do you like popcorn? With or without butter? All of these questions, what do they mean? Well, if you like watching movies and eating delicious, buttery popcorn, then this next segment is for you. I put together 13 movie quotes from movies everyone should know. Let's go see how well Pax Nation did.
All right, I'm here with
Ian Inman.
All right, and I'm gonna name some movie quotes. All right, first one. Say hello to my little friend.
Avengers Endgame.
Just keep swimming.
Dory.
I'll have what she's having.
Nemo. Finding Nemo.
A boy's best friend is his mother.
The first Avengers.
My mama always said life was like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get.
Forrest Gump.
All right, thank you. All right, I'm here with
Alexis.
All right, so basically, I'm gonna name off some quotes, and you have to name the movie it's from, right?
Okay.
You're gonna need a bigger boat.
I don't. Avengers.
May the Force be with you.
Oh, Star Wars.
To infinity and beyond.
Toy Story.
Just keep swimming.
Finding Nemo.
You is kind. You is smart. You is important.
The Help. I think that's.
That's right. Good job. And then the last one. I feel the need for speed.
Oh, Cars.
All right. Good job. Okay. I'm here with
Miss Petite. All
right.
I got that one right. All right.
And I'm gonna name some movie quotes. You're gonna need a bigger boat.
I have no idea.
May the Force be with you.
Star Wars.
I see dead people.
I have no idea.
I feel the need for speed.
Top Gun.
A boy's best friend is his mother.
I have no idea.
My mama always said life was like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get.
Forrest Gump.
Just keep swimming.
A Nemo.
To infinity and beyond.
Buzz, Toy Story.
All right, thank you. All right, I'm here with
Miss Wilding.
All right, and I'm gonna name some movie quotes. First one, you're gonna need a bigger boat.
Jaws.
I see dead people.
Sixth Sense.
I feel the need for speed.
Top Gun.
A boy's best friend is his mother.
No idea.
Mama always said life was like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get.
Forrest Gump.
And say hello to my little friend.
Scarface.
All right, thank you.
All right, I'm here with Mr. Goldstein. All right, I'm gonna name a movie. Movie quote. You have a name of the movie, right? You're gonna need a bigger boat.
Jaws.
May the Force be with you.
Star Wars.
The first rule of Fight Club is you don't talk about Fight Club.
The Fight Club.
Say hello to my little friend.
Scarface.
My mama always said life was like a box of chocolates and never know what you're gonna get.
Forrest Gump.
You is important, or no, you is kind, you is smart, you is important.
The Help.
And the last one, I see dead people.
Man.